One of the most common things I see people do when they start print on demand is they open a store like this and they essentially just make random designs, some of them that belong to a specific niche and some of them that don't. And then I also see people do something like this, where they essentially make something up, they create their own brand and their own clothing line, and they attempt to become the next Nike. And then the third thing that I see a lot of people that are new do with their store is something like this, where they create really abstract designs. Maybe they are an artist or they just enjoy making stuff like this, and they create these abstract designs and just throw them on a whole bunch of different products. Now in this video, if you're new to print on demand or not getting the results that you want, I'm probably going to be talking about some things that you are doing that are causing you to not get the results that you want. What we're going to cover is the three biggest mistakes that beginners make. I'll show you real examples of these mistakes, and then I'm going to talk a little bit about what to do instead. I'll even include some real examples of some actual print on demand stores as well, so that way you can see a real example of what it is I am talking about. And if you guys enjoy this content, make sure to check out the POD Ninjas Facebook group. This is my Facebook group. There's over 43,000 members. There's a link down in the description. Also, my free step-by-step course. If you want to go through some step-by-step training to actually start your print on demand store, there's a link down in the description. And as always, if you guys enjoy the video, you can really help out someone else to help them to find this content by clicking the like button. When you click the like button, it tells YouTube that this is good content and they should show it to other people. So if you enjoy it and you get value, click the like button. I would appreciate it. So like I said, here is our first store. This is called esinternationals.com. All of the stores that you're going to be looking at today in this video are ones that I grabbed from the POD Ninjas Facebook group. From time to time, I ask people to submit stores to review and put in a video like this. So if you guys wanted to get your store reviewed, you could join the group and watch for that post. But this is probably the most classic example of what people do. We're going to take a look at a couple designs here a little bit more closely. This is like the 9 times out of 10 when someone is struggling with print on demand, they're doing something like this. You can see with this example here, right? Now, before we talk about the actual design and stuff, the store is pretty generic. As we scroll through it, there's really no branding here. This is essentially just a whole bunch of randomness on one store. That's going to be maybe a topic for a different video. But in terms of the actual design here, right, we have a picture of a coffee mug with coffee in it and then a wine glass with wine in it. And it says AM PM, essentially a joke, right? Essentially, you know, joking about someone drinking coffee in the morning and then wine at night. Now, later on, I'm going to tell you what to do instead, and then this is going to make a little bit more sense why this isn't a great option, but there's not really a niche here, right? There's not really a specific interest group. I know some of you might argue and say, well, Joe, it's showing that people love coffee and wine, right? So that's a niche. Well, not really, right? This is kind of abstract. This is something that is not really going to get someone super excited, right? Continue to scroll down. We have stuff like this here, right? This t-shirt here that says, Hello Pumpkin. And honestly, the design is kind of in the middle of the shirt. It should be a little bit higher. It kind of looks funny down there on the stomach. But again, as we scroll through this store, if you're someone that has created something similar, stick around because we're going to talk about some more examples of why this stuff doesn't work. Essentially, you are not targeting any specific really passionate interest group. Now, do some of these things reflect potentially a niche? Maybe, like this one here, the feminism niche. But again, this shirt, how many times has it been done? How many shirts can you find online that say the future is female? Likely thousands. You need to do better than this. And like I said, at the end of today's video, I'm going to show you some real examples of a store that is actually doing quite well. Now, some of you here as well may have the desire to create some sort of a brand, right? To create a clothing line. You can see here, Vosley, right? Essentially, they have created products and just thrown the word Vosley on them, right? Not really a great strategy. No one really knows what Vozly is. If I can get this to load, let's see if we can get to the actual product page. Here we go, right? They've essentially just created these shirts and hats, it seems, with the word Vozly on it. And again, you are essentially becoming or attempting to become the next Nike, right? This is not a great print-on-demand strategy. I don't know anybody that has done well creating their own logo and just throwing it on a whole bunch of random products. There's another option here. This is called GDLVL. I'm assuming it means God level. And it's essentially seems like it is a clothing brand kind of intertwined with the Christianity niche. But again, you know, you're talking about t-shirts and tank tops that just say the logo. They just have the logo on it, right? This is not a great strategy for print on demand. Print on demand is a business model where you're going to be selling products in a direct response environment, which we'll talk about in a little bit. But stuff like this, if you're doing some sort of a clothing line where you're just creating a logo, is also not a great strategy. Now, the third thing, like I said earlier, is this sort of abstract approach where you're basically just, you know, creating these designs and putting them on random products, right? And again, these actually look cool. Like, I'm not saying they don't. These are nice abstract designs, but when it really comes down to it, no one really has any reason to want to buy these, right? There's no niche attached. It's just abstract. I'm not saying that, you know, if you ran an ad for these that you wouldn't get a lot of people, you know, clicking the like button and stuff like that, but I think your sales might be a little bit weak. If you're someone that's just creating abstract things like this or on a different product, you're likely going to be struggling a little bit. And again, before we jump into what I think is a better method for print on demand, I want to just say, like, I don't want to appear to be like someone who thinks that he knows everything. Just for one, I've created a bunch of successful print-on-demand products at this point. I've been doing print-on-demand since 2016. I also run the POD Ninjas Facebook group. There's over 43,000 people there. I also have private coaching programs where I work with people at all levels, beginners, advanced, etc. So I've seen a lot. I have a really good understanding about what works with print on demand and what doesn't, right? Or more so, what doesn't have a high success rate. And everything we looked at today, abstract designs, clothing lines, or just silly, quirky, sarcastic designs are not a great approach to print on demand. Before I show you a real example of a great store, I want to talk a little bit about why print on demand products actually sell, right? They sell because of emotion, right? When someone is scrolling on social media and they see your product, the only thing that is going to drive a purchase is if you speak to them on an emotional level. This is very important to realize because print on demand is a business model unlike any other business model out there. Now, I have shown things like this on the channel before. These are gadgets, right? And these gadgets are things that people would buy because they solve a problem for them, right? This right here plugs into the back of the computer, and then you're going to have access to the ports on the front, right? So if you were going to market this, what would interest people is the fact that it solves a problem for them. Now, when we're selling print-on-demand products, some of the things that you looked at today, t-shirts, tank tops, hoodies, shoes, there's no problem-solving ability there, right? The only thing that's going to get them interested is your niche, right? This is so important to realize that if you don't actually choose a passionate niche, right, something that someone is passionate about or something that they identify with, they're going to scroll right by what you are offering because to them, it has nothing to do with them, right? They don't know who you are. The only thing that's going to get them interested is the fact that the niche that you've chosen actually means something to them, right? That's what makes print-on-demand products sell. So when you think about the couple of stores we looked at today with the random coffee and wine products, right? And again, I know someone can make the argument like, hey, coffee's a niche, but the execution of those, I don't think are that great. Those are pretty basic, pretty silly designs. The second one was clothing lines where someone is just basically creating their own brand, throwing their logo on a bunch of different products and hoping that people fall in love at first sight, right? And then we also looked at abstract designs as well, right? There's no niche there, right? There's nothing attached to it. There's nothing that's going to get someone interested enough to actually want to buy it from them, right? If you're new, you need to figure out your niche, right? You need to figure out who it is you're selling to, why they might be passionate enough to actually buy from you, right? It can't just be things that people like. It has to be things that truly represent who they are. And like I said, we're going to take a look at a store that is doing this quite well in a few minutes, right? After your niche, you got to figure out your product choice. Now, don't go right to a t-shirt. Don't go right to a mug. Really think about this. There's going to be tons of products out there that your niche could actually have a real use for. And if you choose one of those and you create a great design that they want and you put it on a product that they like and that's something that's going to give them some sort of a benefit, you're going to be in a much better spot, right? So let's take a look at a store here that is doing a good job. Now, I have a video on my channel where I actually break down this store that we're looking at here in a lot more detail. We're just going to look at this one collection page today. And if you guys want to check out that other video, I'll put it down in the comments of this video where you guys can just click the link and watch it. But this store is called wanderprints.com. They do an awesome job at choosing a lot of really cool products for a bunch of different niches, right? This is what I'm talking about. You got to actually choose a specific niche, right? Here we are on the camping collection page. You can see that as we scroll through, all of these designs and all of these products are something that someone who really likes to camp, right, would actually have an interest in purchasing, right? Let's check out this product right here, okay? Think about, for example, right, we'll kind of talk about the couple of different things that we've looked at so far today, right? We looked at really abstract shoes, we looked at God level hoodies, and we looked at like coffee and wine t-shirts, right? And now this camping flag, okay, this is a flag that someone who camps a lot would be able to personalize and then also put on their campsite, right? You can see that the name is personalized here. They can also pick different vans, different motorhomes, things like that, right? Picture, right, someone scrolling through social media who is really interested in camping, and how they would react to seeing this. They'd be much more likely to actually purchase it compared to if someone is just creating their own clothing line or doing abstract prints on sneakers or creating really silly coffee and wine shirts, right? The goal of print on demand is to create a winning product. And a winning product is simply put just your niche plus product choice plus design. If you do all three of those correctly, you're going to have a winning product like this camping flag here that you are looking at. If you're not getting the results that you want, it's because you don't have a winning product. And if you haven't actually gotten started yet, you need to actually think about this, right? Is your product winning? Do you have a passionate niche? Are you choosing a product that makes sense, right? Here's an example where the flag makes sense for our niche because they're going to put it on their campsite. And then does your design actually capture the niche, or is it something silly like a glass of coffee and a cup of wine, right? You need to actually think about all of that, right, before you get started. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. Check out the rest of the stuff I have here on the channel. Hopefully something else will help you out as well. And I wish you the best. Thank you for watching.